In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create this plaster or sand material. In this tutorial, I'll show you three ways to create this material, and also introduce you to the displacement effect. This is the most widely known, bump and the noise texture method. We can customize the material like this. This is what I would recommend for any textures with three-dimensional height and bumps. The noise texture node is directly connected to the material output node's displacement. I'll show you why I prefer this method, after showing the third example. This is more advanced bump and the noise texture method. This node looks like a math node, but it's actually a mix RGB node. Basically, we're mixing two noise texture nodes to create a unique pattern, but this method is much slower than the previous two. If we change the multiply factor value, Blender will take time to calculate the result. This node looks good, but why do I recommend the second set of nodes? That's because of the displacement effect. To use the displacement effect correctly, we must have a lot of loop cuts in the mesh. As we can see, since this node is not using the material output's displacement, changing the displacement status won't do anything. Same here. Check this out. That looks fantastic. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.